Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my people. Today's topic is going to be about financial anxiety. Something I think many of us go through. Many of us unfortunately have these thoughts, but we don't really want to speak to our family and friends about it. Because again, we don't really want our parents or our family or our friends to think that we're having thoughts about not having enough money or not be able to pay for bills and, you know, not having enough money, because it's not a nice situation to be in. So I'm hoping this video can bring some benefit to you guys. Inshallah, in the end of the video, I'm going to talk to you guys about solutions and maybe how you can come about thinking more positively about finances and possibly solutions to what you guys can do in making sure you don't really get into those tricky situations. Firstly, I just want to give a massive shout out to you all because you guys have been so super supportive. And so thank you very much. Jazakallah khairan. I really, really, really appreciate it. If you can, just subscribe on the video, like the video, share with those that will benefit. Because I think these sort of videos do benefit the masses, but it's important to get the message out to the people as well. So let's get straight into it. We're going through tough times. Roni is like taking over. And of course, this is going to affect the economy. And I want to speak to you guys in particular and give you an idea of how possibly Roni is going to affect us in terms of economy, in terms of employment, maybe even getting a job, or maybe even getting let go from a job. So I work in recruitment, as many of you guys already know. I've been having conversations with companies already. And most of the companies, in fact, a lot of the companies in manufacturing are already saying, we're going to have to make 20-25% of our workforce redundant. That usually is the first step to a recession happening. Redundancies happening in medium to small size companies, of course, goes on to larger companies making their staff redundant. So that's what I want to speak to you guys about. You need to be prepared, my brothers and sisters, in possibly facing redundancy. You need to be prepared. If you are not in a job already, it is possible that it will only get tougher for you in the upcoming months. I'm telling you guys this now because really and truly, if we can plan 2-3 months ahead, if we can cut back on certain costs, stop paying for Sky, stop paying for Netflix, stop paying for the odd things you don't need to pay for, the gym membership you've had since last year. Honestly, if you can even pull back 100, 200, 300 pounds over 3 months, that's going to be £1,000 and it's going to make a massive difference. So I'm telling you guys this now because you need to start cutting back on the cost that you don't need. And on top of that, start trying to save a lot more because we don't really know what the situation is going to be in 3-4 months time. So the number one thing you can do when it comes to financial anxiety is plan before something happens. So of course, we do not know what's going to happen because it's Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we don't know what's going to happen next week or the next month or next 2 months. However, if we have an idea like Roni and we don't know if employment is going to go up or down, or economy is going to be great or not great, likelihood is it's not going to be great. It's been all over the news. We're likely going to be in a recession. So plan for this now. Plan to save a little bit of money. And so in 3 months time, you have some funds in your account where you know you can get by for the next 2-3 months. So know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives us risk. Let's not shy away from that. Of course, as Muslims, this is the most important thing that we believe. And so usually you guys get a lot of financial advice off YouTube or wherever you get your finance advice from. But the one thing that unfortunately lacks is the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we forget that risk comes from Allah. Everything comes from Allah. However, risk comes from Allah. Your job comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If that job finishes, maybe there's hikmah behind it. There's wisdom behind it. Why your job finished? Maybe because you're going to get a better job in 2-3 months. So we have to accept that whatever is decreed, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever, you know, if we have a redundancy, if we lose a job, have patience. Because the instant you get some bad news, have patience in that moment. Have patience, and then inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for you to deal with that calamity. So we should remember that these things come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should have yaqeen in Allah that if we get made redundant from a job, that Allah will inshallah give us something better in the future. More importantly, do du'a to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it is Allah that's going to give us rizq. It is Allah that's going to give us a new job. It is obviously Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that's going to put us in a good situation. And I tell you, because this goes back again to the element of financial anxiety, that if you have yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you have £5 in your account, you have yaqeen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more. Or inshallah, Allah will inshallah give you a better job, right? If you have that sort of mentality, then it becomes very easy for you to deal with that redundancy at the time, to deal with not having money in a certain period, or not being able to pay bills because you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you out of that position and put you in a better position. Which goes on to my other point. Of course we have to do dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course we have to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we have to do the work ourselves. So if you get made redundant, get back on the phone, get online, start looking for a job. And this shows the importance of having many streams of income. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel, because I'm going to be making videos on how we can increase in our streams of income. We shouldn't just be relying on a job. We should also have different financial streams of income. That's what I really want you guys to understand. Have an element of understanding when it comes to financial literacy, that you shouldn't just have a job. You should have like one or two side hustles that you're making a little bit of money. So even if you get made redundant, it's not the end of the world, because you've got other things going on. So plan for these things, because these things are always going to happen. So make sure it is Allah that gives us risk. However, it is you that needs to put the effort in. It is you that will need to get back on the phone and apply for a job. It is you that if you haven't got enough money coming in from a job, work a weekend, work a Saturday shift, work a Sunday shift, work in the evenings, start a side hustle where you're earning 100, 200, 300 pounds a month. Start that now, so maybe in a year's time you can earn more. But don't just rely on a job. Because when you just become reliant on one income, you are in essence handcuffing yourself to that job itself. And that's the sort of mindset I'm trying to get you guys out of. Also, remember this, guys, that the longer you think about these things, if, for example, you go through a redundancy, if your company lets you go, you get sacked, redundancies happen, maybe your company just shuts down completely, whatever the reason may be, don't reflect on it for too long. Sometimes we fall into this trap of procrastinating, right? We fall into the trap of, oh no, man, I got made redundant. Like, I got sacked. And you get a little bit like sad and you think to yourself, oh no, it's all over. But that's the worst mindset you can have, because the longer you reflect on the fact that you no longer have a job, is less time you're spending on finding a new job or finding new streams of income. And that's the one thing you generally just need to avoid. So don't delay on applying for jobs. Don't delay on starting a side hustle. Don't delay on starting a business for yourself. Don't delay these things. Learn a new skill if you have to. If something bad happens, don't think to yourself it's just all bad. Maybe there is some wisdom behind it. And so you just need to see past that wisdom. And that's what a Muslim is, right? That's exactly what we are. We're Muslims. So be proud and understand that whatever happens, happens because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala planned for it to happen. So if we have patience in that moment, for sure Allah will give us something better. And so don't reflect on going through hard times. Don't reflect on not having the exact finances that you need at that point, because as long as you keep trying, and this goes on to my most important point, don't ever give up. Just because you don't get a job straight away, just because you don't have the exact high salary right now or the money you need right now, plan in your head how you're going to get that job. Plan in your head how you're going to increase your finances. How are you going to increase the funds? And go on and do it. Because unless you go and take the first steps, it's never going to happen. And more importantly, never give up. Like, just because you don't make money in your first week or 2 weeks or first month or 2 months, it doesn't mean you just give up. Like, the ones who are successful are the ones that keep trying. And that's what a Muslim is. We put our yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we strive in terms of the dunya as well. And of course, Allah will give to the one who has patience and believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. So not to keep you guys too long, but remember, the longer you stress about these things, it clouds your judgment. If you keep thinking to yourself, oh no, I've got no money coming in, oh no, like, I haven't got a job, you might just apply for a job and accept any job because you're worried, you're stressed, and you let your anxiety get the better of you. That's not the solution. The solution is taking 10 steps back, thinking about your whole situation, how much money do you have in your bank account, what's the right sort of job you can go for, what's the market looking like, maybe you want to start a side hustle, maybe you want to start a business. Take 10 steps back, breathe, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, talk to your elders, talk to people, add me up on Instagram, just send me a DM and if you're in that situation, and I will try help you guys as much as I can. Talk to people around you, consult with them, and then make a solution. Because if you have financial anxiety, if you start getting stressed out, you will just make a call on it very quickly. And that's the worst thing you guys can do. And to finish off, it's you guys that are in control of your income. No one else. Like, it's you that has to work a job, work on the weekends, do a side hustle. You have so many hours in the day to make an income, to have an income, that it's only you that's in charge of it. So the more time you're spending stressed and getting anxious about not having enough money or not being able to see success, or, you know, how are you going to pay for this or how are you going to pay for that? Or just go out and make the money, right? So many times people around me, they say, oh man, you need to pay for this, you need to pay for that, oh, you don't save much, or you don't do this. My answer to them is always simple. I just need to go out there and make more. And that's the sort of mentality I want all of you guys to have. If you're on a certain salary and you want more, if you've got made redundant and you need a job, whatever it is, one, think very highly of yourself. It is you who is in control of your income. You can have a job, you can have a side hustle, you can start a business, you can do whatever you guys want. You're not limited in getting yourself out of a trap which you might be in. If you're in a financial trap, if you have a ton of bills, whatever the situation be, it's you that is in control of your income. So either today you can say, that's it, my life's over, or today you can take that first step and say, you know what, I'm going to change my situation. I'm going to try better my finances, better my situation, and start taking the steps towards it. Because one step towards financial freedom, or one step towards getting out of that financial trap, is one step closer to leaving that financial anxiety. And that's exactly what it's about. So I hope this video benefited you guys. And if it did, again, share, like, and subscribe the videos. It means the world. I'm trying to make more and more videos for you guys. So I hope they're benefiting you. And if they are, let me know. Comment below and send me a DM and let me know as well. So Jazakallah khairan. And for me to you, that's all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.